要什么呀？我们来安排，我们来安排。我把海燕给这三列了，所有都是粉丝，都是肉。天哪！
Another day in the office, Wayne.
Yeah, another day. I know the score, mate. You've been around as long as me, I think. You know what I mean?
Yeah, man. So a lot of these fighters that you're with here in a minute, they're going to be fighting on your show on July the 6th, is that right?
Yeah, that's right, yeah. These are all at the start of the career, you know what I mean? It's just a new generation that we're building with. These are all lovely kids.
Tell us who's on the show, Wayne.
We've got Rio, you know, you've seen Rio. Sethi. Charlotte Powell fighting at it. She's fighting a super flyweight now, where she previously boxed at lightweight. I'm looking for her to step up, good at these lighter divisions. Samia, he's come from Bolton. Very good kid. He's going to be flyweight, boxing at flyweight where he should be flyweight. There's his weight there from yesterday. 54 kilo and he's been boxing at 58. I've got Josh Paldino, he's a new kid making his debut. Young James has just come to me. So yeah, I've got these are all, they're all helping each other, they're all around the same weight, they're all working with each other. And the camaraderie in the gym, great.
Good man.
Text bomb, man. You know, each camp I'm learning, as I always say. So, and, you know, I'm learning new things, and I can't wait to show them off in my next fight.
Yeah, I mean, your last performance was way better, wasn't it? But you must be much happier with that.
Yeah. Well, so much happier. You know, I felt more confident in that one. So it brings the confidence going into my next one. So yeah, I can't wait, man.
I mean, I'm loving what I'm seeing from here. Like Liverpool, just, it seems like the next generation coming through Liverpool are all class. We're going back to like a golden era of Liverpool fighters. Is it exciting to be part of that?
Yeah, it's very exciting. You know, you've got the likes of, you know, Nick Ball leading us now, you know, world title just won it. So,
yeah.
And I fight like Nick Ball, so seeing if Nick can do it. If I put in the hard work and dedication, you know, I'll be there sooner or later.
That's right, because someone like Nick, he's always giving away high. He's always having to get in on these taller guys.
Yeah.
You know, your style's like that, isn't it? In and out and like trying to get in close to the taller guys. So. Must give you a lot of inspiration, man.
Yeah, it does. You know, I always watch Nick Ball, even going back to Black Flash shows, you know, watching him where I am now. He was there once. You know, we had 12 fights on Black Flash show. You know, I want to follow his path, you know, go on the Black Flash, the small old show, then build my way up, man, build my reputation up.
Yeah, well, Nick Ball, Zelfa, Linden, they've all done it.
Yeah, they've all done it as well. You know, you've got to look at Zelfa and Linden, you know. I watch them as well, you know, so if they can do it, I can do it.
Top man. So, 6th of July, you're going to be out. And that's round the corner from here, isn't it?
Yeah, literally down the road. So I've sold a lot of tickets. So yeah, it'll be a boss night, man.
Right, make sure you, if you still want to see Rio on the 6th of July, make sure you get them final tickets off him. Because he's looking good, I'm telling you.
Better be quick, man, because they're going out rapid. So yeah, if you can't get tickets, you know, you can watch it on YouTube. And you know, I always appreciate the support. So yeah, thanks everyone for the support. And shout out my main sponsor, Creme de la Hem. Big up, man.
Big up. What's creme de la creme? Food?
Nah, it's like CMOS, you know, all good stuff for you. You know, if you ever need CMOS or something, go down there, say Rio sent you, they might give you a little discount.
Right, I'm going to do that. All right, nice one, Rio.
Thank you very much, Achie.
It's just like a fresh start for me, you know what I mean? It's just like, I enjoy it now. The way previously, I lost the love of it. I lost the love. And I was just like, it was a chore. But now everyone's bouncing off each other, and, you know. Everyone's bouncing off each other. We all come through. All these have come through the grassroots level. And they're all, you know, they're all starting on the Black Flash show and any other show. Like, so yeah, just build them, and just see where we get from there.
Right, James Francis is with me, working hard.
Yeah.
You guys are working hard this morning, aren't you? Is this a typical day for you?
Alright, like, it's one of the, I would say, probably easy day, to be honest. This is not easy, but I would say a bit lighter than other training. Yes, it was hard, like proper hard.
Yeah.
So yeah, it's I like these type of trainings because when you're doing running and when you're doing this in between, you're running your sprints and that, it makes training a little bit easier instead of a bit too heavy on your legs at all times.
Yeah, fair enough, fair enough. Now, are you on the show on the 6th of July coming up?
Yeah, yeah. Yeah? I weren't on it because obviously I've had an injury, I've had a burst eardrum, but yeah, I went to see a private hospital and they said that my ears cleared up. So basically, I was on the show, but I have to come off, but now I'm back on it, so 2.5 weeks ago.
I like following your social media because you're pretty honest about boxing as a sport. It's a tough sport, isn't it? Especially when you're trying to sell tickets, and it's a hard graft, isn't it?
Yeah, 100%. So just if you can help a local lad out trying to achieve what he wants to achieve, then it would be much appreciated. Obviously, it's not easy selling tickets, and it's not easy, like, the everything behind closed doors, all the training, everything that you have to put in it, and the dieting, and everything on top. Obviously, the stress not selling tickets, or not getting as many tickets gone, it's a bit stress on the head. So, as much tickets sold as possible is very good.
I suppose that's why it's good to have these promoters who are on the small or the grassroots, like the Black Flash, because you've always got a platform there where you can get onto, and then hopefully you will start getting picked up.
Yeah,
that's the plan, isn't it?
That is the plan. Obviously, shout out Nick Ball.
Big time, yeah.
World champ.
I'm going to go and see him after this.
Yeah, he's my biggest inspiration. Obviously, small, stocky, and seeing him on Black Flash has been like a little look up to think, where's he gone from Black Flash, and obviously small all shows and stuff. So yeah, shout out big Nick Ball, become world champ. That's the footsteps we want to follow him.
Yeah, and of course, gyms like this is what breeds the future champs.
Yeah.
So, good environment for you to learn in here as well, isn't it? Because you've all got similar size, a lot of you, you're in the similar weight classes and you're all young.
That's the thing, we're all young, hungry, and we're all similar weights with the sparring and stuff. So yeah, we bring each other on, even in training, we push each other. And yeah, it's a very good team. I like it. I've only been here since the start of the year.
Yeah, I was going to say, it's a newish move for you, isn't it? Yeah,
yeah, but I love it. It's got everything. Everything you need as a boxer. It's got everything. Plus Wayne. Massive shout out to Wayne for letting me come down and giving it a go and helping me out each day and giving me some advice outside of life, outside of boxing as well. So in life struggles. So yeah, big shout out to all the team. Thank you.
Top man. Well, listen, James, give us everyone your social media handles.
James Francis Boxing on Instagram. And if you have TikTok, James Francis 231 TikTok.
That's one thing I've never got into, TikTok,
It's a very, you get paid for it.
What does it say on your gum shield?
You pussy.
That's hilarious.
Yeah.
Okay, interesting.
I was writing Jamie Quinn for my debut, because he's like a joker and stuff.
Yeah.
I thought if he hit him with a good shot, I can laugh at him, you pussy. So, yeah, shout out Jamie as well. What a man.
Funny. All right, mate. Good to catch up with you. Good to see you. Nice surprise to see you here, Danny. I'll catch you in a bit.
See you later.
And Liverpool's going strong at the minute. I mean, look at Nick Ball, just got another world champion in Liverpool.
Liverpool is an absolute diamond. If anyone deserves anything, although he doesn't get it for fucking nothing, he deserved to be world champion the first time. I know he's got it. I'm made up for him, and I'm also made up for Paul Stevenson. So, I'm made up. I text Paul straight after the fight. Yo, pivot round out today, okay? So when he's got, you're there, you're smothering in your own way.
Yeah.
So don't smother your own way. Right, you go in too close. So you've got to get the little bit step out to whip in, whip out. You understand? And you're going not to hit him. He's a big thug, fucking hit him.
Yeah.
Don't be afraid of not hitting him. Yeah, you see him dropping his hands, hit him. You see a gap through the middle, hit him. You get me? I'd rather make this mistake here. So what you're doing, right, do it properly.
Yeah.
Okay?
Right, Samir, introduce yourself, man. Introduce yourself, people have not seen you on the channel yet.
Yeah, so I'm Samir Aftab, professional boxer. As an amateur, I was a 5-time regional champion, 2-time international champion, and I got to two national finals as well.
There you go, man. Got it all going on, haven't you?
Yeah, that's it. That's the one. That's the one. I had a good amateur career. Was all right while it lasted. So.
I'm enjoying watching you guys training today. It's a lot of tech stuff going on, isn't there?
Yeah, yeah. You know what? We're coming up to the last 3 weeks of camp now. So yesterday was a really, really hard push. We were like, sprints, and then just as we thought the session was over, he dragged us to the gym. We did 6 threes on the bags, high volume, and it was a really tough day yesterday. And on top of that, Wayne goes, make sure you finish off at home, do some stretching, do some at my local gym, my amateur gym, do some shadow boxing or something like that. And then, so we really had a tough day today, so it's nice and technical.
You're putting the work in, though, that's a good thing. Great sign.
Yeah, trust me, definitely. We're not leaving any stone unturned this time, and leaving everything in the gym as well.
So it's 6th of July you're out?
6th yeah? of July.
Greenbank,
Liverpool.
Not far from here, Liverpool, on your home turf.
And I'm not from here.
Yeah, you're from Bolton, right?
I'm from Bolton, yeah. Home turf for training, yeah. But yeah, I'm from Bolton. I made the trip every day, and I made the commitment to train up here. I just needed a little change. There was nothing wrong with my old team or anything like that. Like, always a big shout out to Ras, my old trainer. He's done everything for me, not just in the ring, outside the ring as well. But I just needed a change. I made the commitment to come up here, and now we drive every day. And on July 6th, it's going to show the sacrifices I made.
You're going to get some people coming from Bolton though, surely, aren't you?
Of course, yeah. On my debut,
making some noise.
Of course, Aki, all the time, man. On my debut, I sold 400 tickets.
Come on.
And you know what? Like, they always get behind me, man, no matter what. So I'm expecting a big crowd as well, July 6th.
I can't wait to see. I'm going to get some clips of you doing some pad work now as well.
Wicked.
Bro, listen, support this guy. What are your Instagram handles?
Yeah, so my Instagram, Samir___, that's all I really use, so give me a follow on that, please.
Go on, follow the guy.
Shout out to Aki as well. I'm going to show you my phone. I've been subscribed to you a long time.
Respect, man. I appreciate that. You know top man.
So thank you, Aki, man.
All right, take care, bro.
Yeah, take care.
Yeah, so okay, a young crop of fighters. And
young crop, yeah.
Yeah, the next generation coming through from Liverpool, yeah?
Yeah, that's the one.
I mean, it's got some class gyms in Liverpool, hasn't it?
Liverpool's got some unbelievable gyms, you know what I mean? Obviously, you know, we've got there's too many to mention.
There's so many there, but they're all great.
You know what, I don't think the coaches get the recognition or the credit they deserve, because there's a lot of quality coaches in Liverpool. You've only got to look at like the championships, like through the amateurs, where every year there's like the Rotunda are there, the Solly are there, Ware are there, Everton Red Triangle are there. Oh, yeah. Ben Shea over the water. There's so many. I can only apologise because I can't correct there. I can't mention everyone. But
So
at that level, they're all building. Yeah, Fighting City, pretty good. And I just like building this crop of fighters. Now that I've got all these, well, that's a show, so I don't have to rely on other fighters who let you down on shows I've done in the past. You know, don't run shows in the past, and then you've got to rely on other fighters, and they let you down, and the ticket sales, and blah, blah, blah. So,
yeah.
You look at Nick, who you just mentioned. Nick had 11, 12 fights on the Black Flash show.
Yeah. Well, certainly the first few were on the Black Flash, yeah.
Andrew Kane, another one. Brad Strand. All them all stars on the Black Flash. No, you can go on over at Linden's.
Matthew Rennie?
All of them.
Yeah, all of them.
Linden. Yeah. Obviously, you know Linden and Zelfa, but you got Niall now. Niall's just trying to go to him. You know, so it's a can of wind. As soon as you open it, they all come flying off.
My name's Josh Palladino. I'm just turned professional as a boxer. I got my debut on the 6th of July.
Come on, so training here at Golden Gloves. I love a professional debut.
Yeah.
Tell us a bit about your background.
So my background is I started boxing when I was 14, and basically I've been around boxing since I've been a little kid. My dad used to have a boxing gym when I was younger, so I've always been in that environment. You could say that I could have got into boxing down that route, but I did. I got into boxing for myself first and foremost. But yeah, I've been around boxing all my life, and I never look back.
Good man. So where are you from? Because you're not from. Don't sound like you're from Liverpool.
I'm from Preston.
Preston.
Yeah. Right. From Preston. Yeah.
I was going to say, I can't detect an accent.
Yeah.
So how come you ended up in Golden Gloves?
The Golden Gloves, basically, my dad knows Wayne. And I thought, you know what? I'm going to make the change to turn over as a professional. And no better coach to be with than Wayne Smith. You know what I mean? He's done so much in the sport. And
just hold that for a second.
Yeah. He's done so much in the sport. And I can't wait to have the journey with him.
Now, style-wise, I've got a little bit of a hint there, but just tell us like what we can expect from you style-wise as a boxer.
Style-wise, I want to be able to do everything. I want to be able to be adaptable. I want to be creative. you know, I don't want to be one of those fighters that just, he's just an aggressive fighter. I want to be a fighter that can do everything and adapt to any situation, because at the end of the day, you have to adapt to any opponent that gets put in front of you. So that's the type of style that I embrace.
What are you looking forward to most about your professional debut? Because it's sometimes people can get nervous. Sorry, yeah. That's a little bit lower just there. Yeah. Sometimes people can get a little bit nervous, but you know, you seem like not the sort of guy that's going to be. You seem like you're relishing it at the minute.
No, I'm cool, calm, collected, and obviously you get a little bit of nerves because that's a part of the past with the sport. But you know what? I train that hard and I put all the work in the gym that it can't not work out for me. So as long as I dedicate myself, keep the discipline, keep the commitment up, then there's no reason why I can't go out there and win my professional debut or any other fight in my career.
And ticket-wise, people need to get in contact with you. Are you selling your own tickets?
Yeah, I'm selling my own tickets. Yeah, you've got £40 standard, £70 ringside. Come and support your local lad from Preston, and we'll bring over a car from Preston to Best Believe in Liverpool.
You heard the man, and I think I'm going to have the pleasure of commentating on your debut.
100%.
So, even more reason for you guys to tune in on the Black Flash Promotions YouTube channel to watch this show live. But if you can, get down to Green Bank to 100%. Support these fighters. Right, well, we'll be following your career. Tell us your social media handle.
So my social media handle is josh.palladino, Joshua Joseph Palladino on my Facebook, and that's all my social media platforms. I also want to say a massive thank you to my sponsors, AP Broom Landscapes, Riverside Plumbing Supplies, and Ian Bradley Construction Limited. Thank you very much, because without you sponsors, this journey wouldn't be possible. Thank you very much.
No, Marcel, I can't forget Marcel. Do you know what I mean? He started on the shows and, you know, hopefully he goes on to do bigger and better things now, you know?
Well, yeah, now you mentioned Marcel, you've parted company with each other, let's say.
Yeah. Well, me and, like, Marcel, we've had a great journey together, you know what I mean? You know, we've won numerous titles together. He's, you know, relationships end, and, you know, I just wish him all the best. That's all I can do. I wish him all the best. I'll always stand by him, no matter what. I'm a bigger man than anybody. And yeah, the relationship's finished, and it's time. After we went to South Africa, it's just time to move on, you know. He just needs a fresh start, and good luck where he's going. Good luck to him.
Fair enough. All right, cheers, Wayne. I'll catch you in a bit.
No problem, my mate.
Hi, my name is King Safi, and I'm from Afghanistan.
And he is an all-action fighter, this guy, I can tell you. Remember when I first met you, you promised all action, and you have delivered. You're an all-action guy. And I believe you're out again on the 6th of July, is that right?
Yeah, I'm out 6th of July. Been working extremely hard, ready to go.
You've been sparring some good kids as well, haven't you? Tell us about this.
I've been sparring Dennis McInnes. I've been sparring a lot of, even I don't know the name.
Dennis McCann, man. Dennis McCann is one of the best prospects in the country.
I spar him. It's a good experience for me.
Yeah.
Besides, I spar a lot of other kids as well.
Yeah.
I think I'm in that top level, so I'm going learning with each camp. I'm getting better. Yeah. Becoming to achieve my dream. Each step, I'm getting forward.
How did you end up sparring Dennis McCann?
It was good, good. At first few rounds, it was like to get his style, his speed, and especially he's fighting 12 rounds, so and he has a 15 fights, you know.
Yeah,
it's good. I boxed him against him, it was okay, you know, it was good.
Yeah.
I learned him a lot.
But how did it happen? So how did you get the phone call, or did Wayne tell you we're going to go spar Dennis?
I think at first we got a phone call, so I spar Dennis McGann. I was like, oh my God, why not? I want the best, you know. So,
great experience. Yeah,
great experience. So, and the next, I sparred two times. I think it's good to be choosing in best someone in camp, you know. I think it's showing my level, so I'm in that level that I'm choosing, you know, to spar them.
Tell us about what we can expect to see from you then on the 6th, man.
On 6th July, been working so hard, even I have so many things on my head going on back home, my family. But still, I've been working hard. I think it's going to be a good show. It's going to be a real King Safi coming to show, because my last two fights, I was sick in the ring. I was like, oh God, I can't even box. I'm sick. But different mentality, so I'm going to step in the ring, so just go boxing.
But you've had a hard life, man, haven't you? And a long journey to get into the boxing anyway, haven't you?
Yeah, that's what keeps me keep going. You know, I have big dream. I want to achieve my dream, no matter what. I'm here for a reason. I'm here to make legacy, not for money. Now, I'm just be number one.
Good man, good man. Give everyone your social media handles, bro. They need to follow you, don't they?
Yeah. I want to thank Nasby, my sponsor, who followed me my journey. And I want to thank my coach, Sven Smith, my boxing team all. They worked extremely hard to put me in that show, to show my skill, my talent to the world.
Yeah.
We're coming to the top, Primus.
Respect,
watch
man.
Out.
What's your Instagram handle?
My Instagram is KingSafi57.
Get make on sure KingSafi57. Give him a follow, bro.
Yeah.
Right, thank you, man. We'll let you get back to training.
It was nice.
S&C and all nonsense like that, mate. Boxing. You get me?
I get you.
Right, Hakeem Palmer is with me. He's 5-0, one draw, unbeaten. He says he's 6'5", but I reckon you're a bit taller, man. You've definitely grown since I've seen you.
Well, literally, everyone says the same thing when they haven't seen me for a while.
You're fighting in Dubai next. Now, this is big, man, because it's a big away day, so to speak, on a big show on DAZN. Tell us about how this show came about.
Well, thanks to Stephen for getting me on the bill over in Dubai. Now it's time for, it's on DAZN as well, so I can showcase my skills to everyone. Everyone can see what I'm about, really see what I'm about.
I mean, all young fighters want to get a phone call saying they're on a show, but when you got a phone call saying you're on a show in Dubai, what was going through your mind?
No, it's fight to fight. Doesn't matter where it is, whether it's in behind closed doors or on the big a big stage like this one, so it doesn't matter. I just got to get in there, get the win, and show how good I am as I do.
Have you been matched up yet?
Yeah.
So tell us a little bit about your opponent.
He's from India, Indian lad. He's got a good record. He's a winning record. He's coming to win. He's coming to fight. Obviously, all opponents come to win. He's coming. He's obviously so. Yeah, I'm ready to beat him up.
That could be a bit spicy in the press conference then.
Yeah, could be.
How tall is he, do you know?
I haven't got a clue. I mean, not as tall as me.
No, I doubt he can be as tall as you. But you are massive for the weight. Huge for the weight. I mean, you've seen tall fighters. I mean, I remember Antonio Margarito was tall for welterweight. And like Jack Cullen, for example, is tall for middle and super middle. So do you often, you know, enjoy having that height advantage and reach advantage? Do you use that to good effect?
Yeah, of course, I use it to good effect. It's all I know. Like, obviously, me being me and so, that's all I know. So, like, yeah, I use my range. But I can mix it too. I can fight on the inside. So, like, whatever. It doesn't matter. I like to fight on the inside, but obviously, boxing, I box too. So, I just keep my range. May as well. It makes my job easier.
Yeah. Well, I remember, obviously, you've got the one slight blemish on your record, which is a draw. I remember I was at that fight. I remember seeing it. And I know you were disappointed, but you've come back like blazing from that, haven't you, really?
Yeah, that should never have ever been a draw, ever, in my opinion, and everyone else watching's opinion, but it is what it is, and what can I do about it?
Does it annoy you? Does it still annoy you?
Yeah, because...
Sounds like it.
It's like a scratch, innit? It's not much to many people, but it's big to me, and obviously it's like a little scratch on my record, obviously, but... What can I do about it? I've just got to learn from it. I learned a lot from it, and just keep moving.
Just keep going, keep winning. Yeah. What did you learn from it? What did you feel like you learned from it?
What did I learn from that? Obviously, sometimes you're not going to have things go your way, and it's obviously he got in there. He was tough. I lost my head a bit and got into a bit of a tussle with him. But I was winning the exchanges, so I fought a one. I picked up a cut off a head clash as well. My first cut. You know what I mean? So. Learned how to deal with that.
Yeah, you're ticking boxes as you go along,
aren't you? Yeah, ticking boxes, yeah.
How many rounds is this fight in Dubai?
Six.
Six, yeah, okay. Yeah. And then after that, I'm presuming that you're going to want to step up in the rounds and everything.
Yeah.
Do it the traditional way. It's great that Steve Vaughan's getting you know, local lads from not far from where he's from on these big shows, though, isn't it?
Yeah, literally. It's can't complain.
He's looking after his own, isn't he?
Yeah, definitely.
It's great to see, yeah. So, yeah, you mentioned the DAZN thing. Now, this is going to be probably the biggest platform you've boxed on so far, isn't it?
Yeah, I was on the DAZN card in February.
Okay.
But obviously, this is bigger. This is, it's going to be in the bio, in a bigger platform, bigger venue, so more eyes will be on the show, like, but it means nothing to me.
Yeah, you're not bothered, you just want to get down to business.
Yeah, I just want to get up, just get me, yeah, get the rounds under my belt, or...
And there's me and Wayne talking about a nice bit of sun and a bit of this and a bit of that, and you're just there to fight. That's a great attitude, though. That's what it's all about, isn't it?
Yeah.
What do you think, then, we're going to see from you in this particular fight, which might make you stand out to new viewers, new people who haven't seen you before?
Saz. Saz, and then what I do, but how I do it. So, yeah. My skills of, the things I do, and how I do it good. You know what I mean? Great, and, obviously, I'll show everyone why I'm special.
There we go. All right, Hakeem Palmer, he's undefeated, and he's coming to you into Dubai on the 19th of July. Make sure you watch it. It's a great show, headlined by an IBF European title fight. So it's a very good show. Some big names on the card from internationally known names. And of course, some local talent like Hakeem Palmer. It's all promoted in by I've forgotten what they're called. I'll have to add that in afterwards. And yes, people like Steve Vaughn, Fight Zone Fight Academy, Dennis Hobson, they're giving these kids good opportunities on international shows. Any final words to all your supporters?
No, see you in Dubai.
All right, mate, take care. Right, boys, I want to hear about this trip to Malta. Tell us about it.
Yeah, it was a good trip, you know, a very hard trip because, you know, it's training in the heat, but I love training in the heat, but you got to learn to put yourself in uncomfortable environments if you want to make it in this sport, so that's why we did the training camp in Malta. It was a good one.
Yeah, Samir, that's pretty nice, isn't it? Like, you know, where he's taking you over to... where have you put that microphone?
I don't even know.
Put that around.
Shall I just hold it?
Yeah, you can hold it if you want. Yeah, it's good to go in your mouth. All the way around. That's
like
it.
There we go.
Come on.
Uncut here.
So, did you enjoy the Malta training camp? And it's nice that Wayne's arranging these things to take you away there, isn't it?
Yeah, do you know what? It was wicked. I'm not even going to lie to you. What an experience. You know, just being in the same environment with people, the same mindset as you. We had Josh, who was getting us up all the time. You know, let's go for a run. And if we didn't go, we'd feel kind of embarrassed about ourselves. And it pushed us mentally, physically. And you know what? I took a lot of the Malta trip. It was wicked.
I mean, it's nice training in the heat as well.
Yeah.
At the minute, it's not really very hot over
here. Yeah, you don't get that weather in the UK. But, you know, we'd love to go back out there again because it was a really good experience for us because, you know, we're getting to know each other a little bit more. Because when you come into the gym, it's just like... You want to get your own training done, you get out there, and then obviously you talk to, you have that banter, but you don't get to know each other as much. Whereas when we went to Malta, we got to know each other a lot more and a lot better, and it was a good experience.
Definitely, adding on to that, you know, it was good team building. We defo living together for four days?
Yeah, four days.
Four or five days, you know, it was good as well, none of us fell out or anything like that. It was all smooth sailing, and we got to know, like he said, really, we got to know each other really well, and thanks to Wayne for taking us out there and waiting for paying for our meals, and I know you don't like us saying stuff like that, but you probably.
Well, I'm surprised because normally a tight house.
nah, he's not proper. Nah,
he's a good guy, really, and he cares about his fighters.
You know what? He really looked after us, man. While we were out there, didn't he?
Yeah, 100%.
Respect. All right, boys. Well, nice to catch up with you again.
Yeah.
And speak to you next time.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you.